Here we have another example of simplifying a trig expression. Notice how everything is already in terms of sine and cosine, and that none of the trig functions are squared, so there aren't any obvious substitutions. The only thing we're left to do is try to add these two fractions together. Remember, to add fractions, we have to have a common denominator. So our common denominator is going to have a factor of 1 plus cosine theta and a factor of sine theta. So we'll multiply the numerator and denominator of this first fraction by sine theta. We'll multiply the numerator and denominator of the second fraction by 1 plus cosine theta. Notice how both denominators contain the same factors now. You do need to be a little bit careful here because this is the quantity 1 plus cosine theta times sine theta. And over here we have the quantity 1 plus cosine theta times the quantity 1 plus cosine theta. So now that we have a common denominator, we can combine these fractions. The denominator is going to be sine theta times 1 plus cosine theta. And then we have to multiply and then combine the numerators. So we'll have sine squared theta plus, there's a plus sign in here. Now we have to FOIL this out. So we'll have 1 times 1, that's 1. Then we have 1 cosine theta plus 1 cosine theta, that's 2 cosine theta. And then we'll have plus cosine squared theta. Now hopefully things will start to simplify here. Now that some of the trig functions are squared, notice sine squared theta plus cosine squared theta is equal to 1. And here we have sine squared theta plus cosine squared theta, so that's 1. Let's rewrite this again. The highlighted part is 1 plus another 1, so we'll have 2 plus 2 cosine theta over sine theta times 1 plus cosine theta. Notice how the numerator has a common factor of 2. If we factor the 2 out, we're left with 1 plus cosine theta all over sine theta, 1 plus cosine theta. Well, 1 plus cosine theta over 1 plus cosine theta is equal to 1. So we have 2 over sine theta, which is the same as 2 times 1 over sine theta, and 1 over sine theta is equal to cosecant theta. So this is equal to 2 cosecant theta. So this one was fairly challenging. Hopefully you can enjoy this process and think of them as little puzzles that you get to solve.